Hello, my dear friends, my dear students. Today we are going to discuss on one of the basic and important topic for the grades 8 onwards. So the name of the topic is rational numbers. Okay, the very first topic is of rational numbers. So students, we know about the rational numbers. The numbers in the form of P by Q, right? First, note down the name, rational numbers. So which type of numbers are said to be rational numbers? We know various different types of the numbers, like natural number, then whole number, irrational number, rational number, even integer, even odd integers, and so on. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the rational numbers. What are rational numbers? Okay. So what are rational numbers? Generally, we define the rational numbers as, what is the definition of a rational number? We can say a number which is expressed or which is in the form, a number in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers, right? If I is the set of integers, then I say that P and Q both are integers, and very important condition is that this Q must be a non-zero integer always. Okay, so such a number in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is always non-zero, is said to be a rational number. A number in the form of P by Q is a rational number, or is known as a rational number. Okay, so every number which can be expressed in the form of P by Q, where Q must be non-zero and P and Q both will be the integers. Integers means plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, 0, and so on. All the such numbers, the natural number, whole number, and positive, negative. Negative of the natural numbers. So this complete set will become a set of integers, right? So this P and Q must be integer, Q must be non-zero integer. So such a number is called a rational number, right? So student, now after defining the rational number, what are the rational numbers? Now we will discuss about some important properties of rational numbers. What are the important properties of rational number? Means just like we know about the natural number, we know about the whole number, we know about the integers, that all these numbers, natural number, integer, as well as the whole number, they are all having some properties, like closure property. Then we have commutative property. After that, we have the associative property, and so on. So basically we have these three properties for these numbers. Okay, so now we will see these properties for rational numbers. I will just write here the three properties for addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division for a rational number. Okay, so I will just make a table. What is a property? We have a closure property. After that, we have commutative property. And then we have the associative property. Okay, we will discuss these three properties for the addition of rational numbers. Then we will discuss the same property for subtraction of rational numbers. Subtraction of rational numbers, and then we'll discuss about the multiplication. After that, we'll discuss these three properties for the division of two rational numbers. We'll discuss these properties one by one. So first we'll discuss about the closure property. What is the closure property in general? The closure property for any number, not only for rational number, for any number, the closure property will be, we say that addition or the natural numbers are closure, or rational numbers are said to be closed under addition. Okay, For natural number, we can say that natural numbers are closed under addition. Natural numbers are closed under subtraction. Natural numbers are closed under multiplication, and so on. So such property we have seen up to now. Today we will see the closure property for addition. What it means, I will just explain here. Consider the two numbers, say 2 by 3 and 4 by 3. What it gives us? It is addition, so no doubt we need to add two numbers. So what it gives us? 2 by 3 plus 5 by 3. These are the two rational numbers, no doubt. So what is the addition of these two rational numbers? While taking the addition of two rational numbers, the denominators of such rational numbers must be equal. To take the addition, it must be equal. If it is equal, then it will be convenient to add. If they are not equal, then we can make them equal and add. Okay, if they are equal, what we do, we just put the denominator as it is and just add the numerator, but we need to take if denominators are equal, then we can simply add the numerators, right? So what is the addition of this? 4 plus 2 will become 6, and 6 upon 3, it will become 2. Will 2 be a rational number? So obviously 2 will be a rational number, because every integer, here 2 is an integer, 2 is a natural number. So every integer is always a rational number. So because this 2 can be written as 2 by 1, yes or no? So 2 by 1 will again become a number in the form of P by Q, where P and Q both are rational number and Q is non-zero, right? P and Q are integers and Q will be non-zero. Here 2 and 1 both are integers, and this Q, this is nothing but 1, which is non-zero. So it will be a rational number, I say, right? If I denote Q as the set of rational numbers, so I denote that this 6 by 3, which comes as 2, can also be written as 2 by 1, will also be a rational number. So that is the only associative property, right? So this closure property, we say that these rational numbers are closed under addition. So I will write here, yes, or we can just tick mark here. We can say that rational numbers are closed under addition, right? So now we'll check for the commutative, whether rational numbers are commutative under addition, then associative under addition or not. Okay, let us check. What do you mean by commutative? So commutativity property, it means that if we have two rational numbers A and B, if A plus B and B plus A are equal, then we say that it is commutative. So this property is known as a commutative property. So here we will just check for the same example. Here we have written 2 by 3 plus 4 by 3, addition comes as 2 by 1, we have seen. Now I will try to find the addition of 4 by 3 with 2 by 3. What it gives us? Again, I have the denominator same. I have to add up numerators, 4 plus 2, it becomes 6 by 3, and again it becomes 2, which is a rational number. So these two gives us that 2 by 3 plus 4 by 3, it is also equal to 4 by 3 plus 2 by 4, both are equal to 2. So this property satisfies this, that is a commutative condition, that is A plus B and B plus A are equal. If sum of two rational number in any order, either A plus B or B plus A, it becomes same, it will remain same. Here you see both are equal to 2. So hence we can say that rational numbers are closed and they are commutative. We say that rational numbers are commutative under addition, right? Now we'll check for associative. What do you mean by associativity? We say that if you have the three rational numbers, say A, B, and C, then I say that the three rational numbers are associative if it satisfies the condition like this: A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. If it satisfies this condition, then we say that rational numbers are associative under addition, right? So we'll check whether this addition is associative for this rational numbers. Let us check. I will consider one example for this associative property. So for associative property, what I consider here, as I have taken these two numbers already, 2/3 and 4/3, I will take one more number. Suppose 2/3 plus 4/3, I will take 5/3 or 3. Okay, I will take 5/3 only. What will happen? Let us check. Okay. Here for my convenience, I have just taken all the numbers with denoter same. But in the case if they are not equal, we need to make them equal. Okay. So here I write it like this. I add 5/3 to the sum of 2/3 and 4/3. How much it comes? As we know, 2/3 plus 4/3 here we have calculated. It comes as 2. So I will write it as 2 plus I need to add 5/3 to this. How much it comes? Here 2 means 2/1. Here denoter is 1. Here denoter is 3. Here simply I just take the cross multiplication and write the product of denominators. So what it gives us? 3 ones are 3 is denominator. And just take cross multiplication. 3 twos are 6 plus 5 ones are 5. This multiplication plus this multiplication. So 6, 2 threes are 6 plus 5 ones are 5. So how much it gives us? It gives us 11/3. Okay, it comes the LHS. Now I will try this RHS, A plus B plus C. So how it comes? Let us check. A, I will keep this A as it is and just add 4/3 and 5/3 together. What it gives us? It gives us 2/3 plus. I will just add this. Here denominator is again same, 3. Just add the numerator, 5 plus 4, it becomes 9. So it gives us, the denominator remains same. It is 3, I will just add numerators, 2 plus 9, which comes as, again, 11/3. So are these two equal? Yes, they are equal. Means what? What I can say? I can say that A plus B plus C equal to A plus B plus C. So in this case, I say that this addition is associative for rational number. So here I say that I will take this one also. It means for addition, the rational numbers are closed. Addition is commutative for rational number and addition is associative for rational number also. It means all the three properties hold for the addition of rational numbers. Right? So now we'll move for the next algebra, that is subtraction. So let us check for the subtraction. What happened? The first one. We'll check the first property, that is for closure, whether the rational numbers are closed under subtraction or not. So for that, what we need to check? I need just find the subtraction of the two numbers. Here, if I take 4/3 and 2/3 are the two numbers, what will happen? I just keep the denominator as it is, subtract the numerator. How much it gives us? 4 minus 2 gives us 2, 2/3. So is it a rational number? Yes, it is a rational number. So I will say that the rational numbers are closed under subtraction. So here I will just put the tick mark. So what this tick mark indicates? It indicates that the rational numbers are closed under subtraction. Now we'll check commutative and associative for this. Okay, for commutativity, so this is the first one. Then for commutativity, what is the commutative property? It is A plus B should be equal to B plus A. Okay, so I will take the same number, 4/3. It is a difference, right? In case of addition, it is A plus B and B plus A are equal. But for subtraction, it will be 4/3 minus 2/3. Let us check. It should be equal to 2/3 minus 4/3. Let's check. So what this gives us? The denominator is 3. Now numerator will be 4 minus 2. It comes as 2/3. Now I will check the same difference in reverse order. 2/3 and 4/3. 2/3 minus 4/3. How much it gives us? The denominator remains same. Numerator is 2 minus 4. How much is 2 minus 4? Yes, 2 minus 4 will become minus 2, right? And this gives us the ratio, the rational number in the form of minus 2/3. So tell me whether these two are equal, whether A minus B and B minus A are equal. The first one is A minus B and the second one we got is B minus A. So are they equal? A minus B gives us plus 2/3. B minus A gives us minus 2/3, means they are not equal. So here what I say, we say that the subtraction is not commutative for rational numbers. So here I put the cross mark in this tabular form. So here, since they are not equal, a minus b and b minus a are not equal, here I say that the rational numbers are not commutative and the subtraction, or we can say the subtraction of rational here is not commutative for rational number. Now I will check for associative property. What is associative property? Associative property means we need to take the three numbers and we'll check the subtraction of them in order by making the groups of any two together. So let us check 4 by 3 minus 2 by 3 minus 5 by 3. As we have taken previously the three numbers, we take the same. 4 by 3 minus 2 by 3 minus 5 by 3. How much it gives us? We have calculated here it is 4 by 3 minus 2 by 3 is 2 by 3. And this is minus 5 by 3. So how much it gives us? This is 3. 2 minus 5. It is minus 3. It gives us minus 1. Now I'll check. I keep 4 by 3 as it is. And just take 2 by 3 and minus 5 by 3. Together. So what this gives us? It gives us, if I take it like this, what will happen for commutative to associative property? When I take this minus sign common, this will become plus, obviously, right? Because all the numbers are negative, and if I had taken this minus sign as common for these two, so the sign will change. So it gives us 4 by 3 minus. So here I need to take the sum. So denominator remains same. 5 plus 2 will become 7. So here we're left with 3. So 4 minus 7. How much it is? 4 minus 7 is minus 3. Right? Minus 3. And it gives us again minus. How much it is? Minus 1 again. So what we say here, what we can say, whether subtraction is associative for rational number or not. It is an exceptional example for which we are having these two are equal. Have done everything okay. Here 4 by 3 minus 2 by 3 minus 5 by 3. And we do the same. I think we have done some mistake. So instead of making this minus, because here we are not applying that that rule, but just we are putting them together. Okay. So for that, no need to change the sign. So that we have here 2 minus 5 is minus 2 minus 5 will be minus 3 by 3. Okay, this minus minus will become plus, and 4 by 4 plus 3 will become 7 by 3. This gives us plus 7 by 3. So are they equal again? You can check. Here you can conclude from this that these two are not equal. Means A plus B, sorry, not plus. We need to take the difference. A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B minus C. We should check this one only. No need to bother about the sign. Okay, just put this bracket for first two and the second two. For the left side, we take the first two numbers in one bracket, and to find the RHS, just take the next two numbers in bracket. Okay, so it will be like this. So it gives us these two are not equal. So what it says? It says that again, that subtraction is not associative for rational numbers. So here again, I put the cross sign for this, that subtraction is not commutative for, it is not associative for rational numbers. Is it clear for all? Now let's move for the multiplication. We'll check for multiplication, whether that multiplication is closed, is commutative, is associative. Let us see. So again, consider the same numbers, 4 by 3, 2 by 3. Okay, I will check the product. 4 by 3 into 2 by 3 will become 4, 2 are 8 and 3, 3 are 9. While taking the multiplication of any two rational number, we just multiply numerator with numerator, denominator with denominator. That is a simple way to get the multiplication of rational numbers, right? So it gives us 8 by 9. So what is 8 by 9? Is it a rational number? So obviously it is a rational number. So what I say here, I say that multiplication or the rational numbers are closed under multiplication. Here I say that rational numbers are closed under multiplication. Okay, so I will just put the tick mark in that tabular form. Here it is, in the first page we have. Yes, here I can say that rational numbers are closed under multiplication. Now I will check for commutative property. So again, as we know the commutative property, what is commutative property? A into B equal to B into A, right? So A, again, we take 4 by 3, B we take 2 by 3, take the multiplication. So what it gives us again, we got it already as 8 by 9. Now I calculate 2 by 3 and multiplication with 4 by 3. Multiplication of 2 by 3 with 4 by 3, just taking, changing the order of these two numbers. So what it gives us? Again, it gives us the same multiplication of denominator is 3 to the 9. Product of numerator is 4 to the 8. Again, they are equal. So what this gives us, what it shows, from this we can conclude that A into B and B into A both are equal. So what I say here I can say that multiplication is commutative for rational numbers. I will say that multiplication is commutative for rational numbers, right? So here I will just put again one more tick mark in the column for multiplication. Here I say the rational numbers are commutative, or multiplications are commutative for rational numbers. Now I'll check for associative property of this multiplication. So what to do in this case? We take the division of three rational numbers. So here I'll write 4 by 3 divided by 2 by 3 divided by 5 by 3. We take these three numbers as we have taken in all these three cases. So first I put these two in one bracket, and secondly 4 by 3 divided by 2 by 3 divided by 5 by 3. So in this case, I need to put these two in one bracket. Okay, forget about that rules. So first I take the division of these two, 4 by 3. So division of two rational numbers will be multiplication with its reciprocal. So 4 by 3 into will become 3 by 2. Okay, this kept as it is 5 by 3. So what this gives us, this 3, 3 gets cancelled, this 2, 2 are 4. It gives us only 2 and is divided by 5 by 3. So 2 means 2 by 1. So I will rewrite it as 2 by 1 into 3 by 5, or it will be 3, 2 are 6 upon 5. Okay, so now I will check for this. Wait, what are done? Sorry. Okay, we are discussing about the multiplication, no? So I have taken the division. We'll just discuss about the multiplication associative property. So what is associative property for multiplication? A into B into C is equal to A into B into C, right? So here I will just rub this part, and then we'll discuss about that. Yes, commutative property for multiplication. So I will take 4 by 3 into 2 by 3 into 5 by 3. Okay, so taken these two together, it should be equal to 4 by 3 into taken 2 by 3 and 5 by 3 together. What this gives us? It gives us again 4 to the 8, 3 to the 9 into 5 by 3. What this gives us now? 9 to the 27 and 8 5 are 40. So it is 40 by 27. So keep it as it is. No need to simplify. So I will keep 4 by 3 as it is in this case. Take the multiplication of these two, 3 to the 9, 5 to the 10, and again take the multiplication. 9 3 are 27, 10 4 are 40. So are they equal? Yes, they are equal. So since they are equal, I can say that A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. That is what I say. I say that the multiplication is associative for rational numbers. I will say that multiplication is associative for rational numbers. Rational numbers, right? So multiplication is associative for rational numbers. So here again, I need to put one more tick mark here for multiplication. So here I say that this multiplication is closed. It is commutative as well as associative for rational numbers. Now I will check for division. So let us check for division, whether that division is closed, whether it is commutative or associative. Let us check. So I will check the division of two rational numbers, 4 by 3 and 2 by 3. What this gives us, as we know, the division of two rational numbers, I can convert in multiplication by taking the reciprocal of this second term, which is to be divided. So here 4 by 3 into this 2 by 3 will become 3 by 2. So what this gives us is 3, 3 gets cancelled. This will become 2, 2 are 4. So I get the division of these two rational numbers as 2. So now what about 2? Is it a rational number again? Yes, we can say it is a rational number. Okay, it is a rational number here. 4 by 3 divided by 2 by 3 is rational number. But what we can say here, will this property hold for all the numbers? In the case if I divide this by 0, what will happen? What will happen if I divide it by 0 in that case? What will happen? Because 0 is also a rational number, right? 0 is also a rational number. So if I divide this number by 0, what it gives us? Any number divided by 0, as we know, a number divided by 0, it is not defined. So such number is not defined. So since it is not defined, here we say that this property does not hold. Means division, or we say that rational numbers are not closed. Very important here, the rational numbers are not closed. Rational numbers are not closed under division. So this is very, very, very important. Even if here in this example, we are getting this as 2, no doubt, it will be a rational number. But even for a single number, if this property does not hold, then we say that it will not hold for that rational number. Means we can say that the rational numbers are not closed under division. So that is the first one. That is, they are not closed. Closer property fails here. Now we'll check for the second one, commutative. So commutative means what? 4 by 3 divided by 2 by 3. It should be equal to 2 by 3 divided by 4 by 3. Let us check. So 4 by 3 divided by 2 by 3, what this gives us? 4 by 3 into 3 by 2. So how much it gives us? Here it gives us 2 again. Okay. Now I will check for this. 2 by 3 into 3 by 4. How much it gives us? Here it is 2 to the 4. This 3, 3 gets cancelled. It gives us 1 by 2. And this gives us 2. So are they equal? They are not equal. Right? 2 and 1 by 2 are not equal. You can check this this property for any two rational number students. Not necessarily we need to take only this such numbers only. We can take any two rational number and check. If it fails for at least a single such pair of rational number which this gives us equal, then in that case we can say it is not. Okay, here for this number they are not equal, so we can say that the division is not closure. Here I can say that division is not, here it is commutative. Division is not commutative. Is not commutative for rational numbers, right? For rational numbers, so division is also not commutative. It was not close, now it is not commutative. I will check the third one also, that is associative property. Since this it is not commutative, it is not closed, I think this third property will also not hold. We will check it. 4 by 3 divided by 2 by 3 divided by 5 by 3. I am taking three numbers, okay? Taken first two numbers together. Now I will check 4 by 3 upon 2 by 3. It comes to your senior and it is divided by 5 by 3. So how much it gives us? Again, it gives us 2 into 3 by 5, which gives us 6 by 5. Now I'll check, taken 4 by 3 aside, and taken 2 by 3 and 5 by 3 together. So it gives us 2 by 3 divided by 5 by 3 will be equal to 4 by 3 remain as it is, and it is divided. So here this 2 by 3 divided by 5 by 3 will become 2 by 3 into 5 by 3. What this gives us, this 2 2 gets cancelled. So you're left with 4 by 3 divided by, now what I have here? I left with 5 by 3, so it is divided by 5 by 3. So again, I will rewrite in multiplication by taking it in reciprocal form. Okay, so here this 3 gets cancelled. So here, student, what we say that 4 by 3 divided by 2 by 3 divided by 5 by 3, taken the second last two terms together, last two numbers together, we are having this as a 6, this 4 by, what we are having? We are having 4 by 5. So they are not equal here. This here we are having 6 by 5, this one is having 4 by 5, they are not equal. So what this shows, it shows again that A by B divided by C taken A and B together is not equal to A by B by C taken B and C together. So they are not equal, means associative property does not hold. So what we can say again here, we can say that division is not associative. So the third property we can say that division is not associative. Division is not associative for rational numbers, right? So this is for rational numbers. So students, so it's a very important concept, not for rational numbers. So here I need to again mark in the table above, we are noted. Just mark, cross mark in the associative property of division of this rational numbers. See on the first page. Yes, this is the table here. So here if we see for the division, we've seen that the rational numbers are not close under division. So I put cross mark here. Then we have seen that division is not commutative for two rational numbers, and also we have seen that division is not associative for the rational numbers. So in this way, student, we have discussed about the very important properties of rational numbers, right? So if you see here, these are very important properties, and we have discussed those properties. First, we have seen the property for addition of two rational numbers. So we say that addition is closed, or the rational numbers are closed under addition. We have seen that addition is commutative for two rational numbers. It is also associative for two rational numbers. So here I say for addition, it is closed, commutative, as well as associative. But in case of subtraction, we have seen it is closed. The subtraction is closed, or we can say the subtraction is closed under this rational numbers, or we can say rational numbers are closed under subtraction. Okay, and then we have seen for multiplication. Multiplication in all the three properties holds for the multiplication of the rational numbers, and for division, again we say that division does not hold any of these properties, right? So student, this table will play a very important role to understand the properties of rational numbers for multiplication, that addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. These are the three very important properties here. They are namely closed property, that is closure property, then commutative property, and then associative property. So you can just make a note of this table, keep it in your mind, and just try to understand the concept of these three properties for the four algebras of rational numbers. So here we say that these properties will not hold for subtraction, that is commutative and associative, only closure property holds, and for division all the three properties will not hold. So these are the three properties, all the three properties will not hold for division of rational numbers. So students, we have discussed about the very important concept of the properties of rational numbers. So if you know about, if you come to know, or if you understood this concept of the properties of rational numbers, it will be very easy to solve the example on this part of, or that, what we say, we can say that it will be very easy to solve the example on the part of these properties of rational numbers from the exercises. So the exercise will have the example on these properties only. So with this, students, so today we will stop here only. We will have many videos to come on all the topics from grade 8 onwards till grade 12, as well as the diploma engineering, as well as the engineering students. With this note, today we will stop here only. In the next session, in the next video, we will see the example on this part of this topic. Thank you, everyone. See you all in the next video. Thank you.